This week on American Airgunner, we head up to northern Michigan with Up North Airgunner Chris Turek, shooting bolts with the FX Crown. He'll try his luck bagging a nice velvet antler buck.
Hey everybody, Chris Turek, the Up North Airgunner. I am here with American Airgunner at the Ultimate Whitetails Ranch. And today we are going to be doing an early season whitetail deer and velvet hunt. This is my first time going on this kind of hunt. It's super hot here for Michigan. It's in the mid 80s, which is pretty hot for us Michiganders, but it's gonna be absolutely an epic hunt. Now the hard thing about doing these kinds of hunts in the early season with it being this hot, deer are not moving. They are not moving like they are during the rut. So we spent the last 3 days scouting this location, and there are some monster bucks out here, but they're just not moving right now. There's no chasing, there's no rutting activity. They're pretty much just kind of being lazy during the day. There's a lot of activity in the evenings, early mornings. So during our scouting, what we have found is that they like hitting water sources about 4 or 5 times during the day. So what we're gonna be doing, we're gonna be setting up near a water source, and hopefully we get lucky. All right, so check it out. We're gonna be doing some terminal ballistics testing, and to mimic the body of a deer, what we've got here, we've got some pork ribs, we've got a watermelon to represent, let's say, like the lungs, like the inner vital areas of a deer, and we are gonna put this deer hide over the top from Ross's doe that he got yesterday. So right here, we're gonna put that over the top, and that is gonna be a pretty darn good representation of what kind of penetration we're gonna get with these single bevel broadheads. Let's check it out. All right, here we go. 20 yards. That looked awesome. Center punched it. Look at this penetration. Down to the fletch. Now these are pork ribs that we're using in here, and which are much thicker than a deer rib. So on a deer, I probably expect that's gonna get a full pass through on that. But I mean, look at that absolute devastation as that single bevel is just twisting its way through the game animal. So proof is right there, baby. So we got to our tree early morning, right before daybreak. We got up into the saddle hunting position. It's a perfect spot. The water source is right behind us. And right away, this monster buck came out. We've got so much foliage right now, there's just no way to get a shot through these trees. So he was over my shoulder, about 15 yards away. My heart was just pounding